colleague Raman said, we have started this vision in 2006, say about 10 years back, with a small number, with a mission of impacting high quality education to the students to achieve their goals. Our focus is on maximizing our impact on more students rather than a few. We not only focusing on getting the higher ranks, best ranks, we are more focusing on getting more number of students get into medical seats in various colleges of Karnataka. Every year, 70 to 80% of our students are getting medical seats in various colleges of Karnataka.
They've introduced me. I have only been 6 years in service. So before 6 years, or before 7 years, so to say, I was exactly in your position. So throughout our childhood, we are told that first standard, second standard, then seventh standard boards were very important. Then 10th standard, if you get a very good score, your life is set. Then you realize after 10th, oh, it's not over. We still have to pass PUC exams. Then PUC happens, then you finish PUC, then you say, no, no, it's just not done. You still have your CETs and MSETs and other exams to pass. Then you finish that. And then you think, okay, you've finally arrived in MBBS or engineering or any graduation of your choice. And then you go through graduation. Most of us are not sure whether it was right for us to have chosen this field or not. Most of us would have listened to our parents. Like in Andhra, it's either MPC or BIPC. There is no other way or choice for students. So throughout graduation, MBBS, Maduaga, and in that process, many of us would discover whether we really like what we are doing. So MBBS agatade or engineering agatade. Towards the end of it, after 4 or 5 years, we still think, ki now what? Now, I mean, what am I going to do? Am I going to do an MD? Am I going to pursue medicine? Or should I start practicing? These are the questions. These are all the questions even I have faced when I was maybe 7 years back. After I finished my engineering graduation, I thought, okay, what do I do? Because what we think of a profession, what we study is not what the field is. There's this Kumar Mangalam Birla, all of you must have heard of. So when he was addressing these MBA graduates, he told them that MBA, all these IIMs and all these B schools, they can teach you case studies, but they can never teach you what the real life is, because it cannot be taught also. You can have life experiences being told to you, but it's very difficult for someone to teach you how the real world is going to be. And it is only a thing that what you have studied till now is only one part of it. What you're going to do from now on with your life and your careers is another part of it. So it's going to be a different journey now. Whatever schooling, education, everything you've had till now is one part. It has been the good part, I must say, and what you're going to face now is going to be very challenging. And how you face this is very important. It's important to know what is it we are going to face. So maybe 7 years back, even I had this thought, ki, what do I do now? Like most people think that I never prepared for the exam from childhood. Ki, it was not my dream that I should get into the service or something like that. It happened after my graduation. So most of you are now finished your MBBS. So all of you are at a crossroad of what to do in your lives now. Well, I can't tell what each of you can or should do, but I can only share some important, probably life lessons, which I have learned at least in the past 6 to 7 years. So all of you students, of one of the things we think is life is very unfair. There are a lot of struggles. Either we are not rich enough, or we don't have supportive parents, or they keep scolding us, or so many things we find. And namge, we keep telling ourselves that these are our struggles in life. But if you look at it, our ancestors were fighting wars. You know, they were facing life and death situations. What we face now is not very big. But then each of us have to face whatever struggle it is in life to come out with something which is very beautiful, which is life itself. So all of you students of biology, you all know, I'll just like to narrate a small story of a butterfly. There was a guy who was passing through a jungle or somewhere, and he saw a small cocoon. Then he saw the small earthworm was really struggling to get out of the cocoon. So what he does, he takes out a pair of scissors and just cuts the cocoon a little towards the head. So the earthworm is easily able to come out. But when it comes out, he sees that it has a very bloated body and small wings. They have not yet developed. So he keeps waiting. He's been a very kind man. He thinks that he's helped the earthworm through its struggle. So he keeps looking at it. Hours pass by and nothing happens. He hopes that the wings will expand and all. But he didn't realize that the struggle which the earthworm has to go through to come out of the cocoon squeezes the liquid out of its body and expands its wings, enabling it to fly its entire life. So what he has in his kindful state of mind done to the earthworm is it has reduced its life to a redundant life of having a fat, bloated body with small wings, and it could never fly. So what I am trying to say out of the story is that struggles are very important in life. What you're going to face from now on is really, really very important. And it's also important not to give up, because there's always something which we do not know towards the end of the thing. If only the guy knew that there's this beautiful butterfly will come out of its struggle, he would not have cut probably the cocoon.
Yes, please keep applauding them. Please put your hands together. This is a great celebration time. A time to celebrate. We have our honorable guest.
Hello everyone, this is Dr. Avinash Shivnal here. Currently I'm doing my MD at JNM Medical College, Belgaum. I belong to the first batch of Vision Pugh College. So I've been associated with this institution since around 8 years. Now talking about the college, the history itself speaks a lot about about college, because within the span of a decade, they have become a renowned institution for PUC education and also getting through entrance. And they have helped out various students, so many students, to get through their entrance exam. Now, one different thing and good thing about this college is that compulsion exists in every college, compulsion towards education, compulsion towards the daily activities. But here in this college, compulsion is there to a certain extent, but the most important thing there in this college is the orientation which you get. Orientation is the most important thing, I think, which plays a role in a student getting through an entrance exam. The orientation, the creation of interest, because every student is different and you have to let every student do him or her in his own way, so that they get through in a better and a good environment, rather than just getting through with all the depression and all those expressions. They need not do that. They have to get through their own way. So a college which lets you do it, which lets you develop your own interests along with studying, and it also gives you a little responsibility regarding what you would like to do, what you would do, rather than what others are advising you to do. I think that holds a lot of importance in how a college works, rather than just compelling students. So this is a very good college in that regard, and they are at constant pace. They are improving every day. Day by day, the institution is going to higher and higher levels. So I really appreciate the institution for that, and congratulations Vision College, including the directors and also the people who are the part and parcel of Vision College. Thank you so much.
Now, we started Vision with a mission to provide a quality education to the students. We have we've been in the industry for the last 10 years. We know that we have to do a lot, but we have touched more than thousands of students in the last 10 years. And we continuously improve the quality of the education, and our objective is clearly to provide quality of the education for students to realize their dreams. Particularly last year, over 320 people have realized their dreams of becoming or getting into medical colleges, and many in the past. We continue to do the same in future. In fact, our aim is not about the quantity, it's about the quality. We want to provide the quality education to as many students as possible. That is that's why we started the education.
The number of the students, how many numbers of students currently?
Currently we have about 2,500 students, and we expect about 4,000 next year. And we're starting another campus this year, so we continue to add more campuses as we get the students. But again, you know, we want to have a controlled growth. We don't want to lose our quality. We want to minimize our growth not lose the control on quality of the education we provide. So that is what we're doing here.
Is there any special any arrangement done for the poor students? Can they afford it? How much does it cost?
What we have been doing is we have set aside quite a bit of scholarship. Like for example, last year we had about 40 lakh scholarship, which we give for economically backward students in the form of discounted fee. And in fact, most of them today are in medical colleges. And we continue to increase our pool of scholarship. And we understand the need for economically backward students. We would give decent scholarship for them to be able to get through this education, and where there is a need, we'll help them further in future as well.
Is there any hostel facilities provided for boys and girls?
Yes, we have separate hostels for both boys and girls. We have many hostels. I would say good 80% of our students are in the hostels.
Yeah. The main course would be only engineering and medical?
We started with science, both for engineering and medical. A couple of years back, we started commerce, and we started degree college, both with BCom and BBA. And we have plans to add more, which will be focused towards towards getting jobs in undergraduation.
Yeah. If a student wants to get a medical seat,
yeah,
how much he has to spend per year? The 10 month of course, actually, how much does
it cost? As I said, it depends from year to year, and typically it ranges, from tuition fee point of view, it's about 80,000 rupees tuition fee. And then there is a hostel fee. If someone wants to stay in hostel, there is a hostel fee in addition to the tuition fee. But tuition fee is typically under 1 lakh.